Genial.
Good afternoon, students. So far in last class, we have completed k-means algorithm and bisecting k-means algorithm. So in the bisecting k-means algorithm, we have to apply the iterations. So after 10 iterations, we have to perform. So finally, you can get the diagram like this. That is the bisecting example. So this is the algorithm. Generally, in the k-means algorithm, you have the only 5 steps. But whereas in bisecting k-means algorithm, you have the total 8 steps. Initially, the bisecting the k-means algorithm. Simply, you can say that variant of k-means that can produce a partitional or hierarchical question. So here, first initialize the list of clusters to contain the cluster containing all points. And first, what are the data points you have? All the data. What are the data points you have? All the data points you have to group into the clusters. That is the first initialize the list of clusters to contain the cluster containing all data points. So all data points must be in the cluster. Then that is the first one. That is the initialization of the cluster, list of clusters. And the second step you can perform, repeat the loop. That is the repeat, select a cluster from the list of clusters. And one cluster you have to select from the list of clusters. In that cluster, for I equal to 1 to the number of iterations do, bisect the select cluster using basic k-means. So you can perform this first cluster, and a similar way you can perform all the clusters. So after performing the iterations for the all clusters, now you can add the two clusters from the bisection with the lowest SST to the list of clusters. So until you can add the lowest SSCs to the list of clusters. Finally, you can until the list of clusters containing the K clusters. So this is the bisected k-means algorithm. So first one is the k-means algorithm. Second one, bisecting k-means algorithm. Next one, this is the example for the iteration of 10. Limitations of k-means. So in the limitations of k-means, k-means has the problems when the clusters are differing with the characteristics like sizes, densities, and non-globular shapes. K-means has the problems when the data contains outliers. So here the limitations of k-means with the different sizes. So here first we have to represent the squares and circles and triangles. So here this is the original points, and k-means you have to represent the three clusters. So boxes where we have the few, actually this is the clusters, three clusters we have to represent it. After k-means we have to apply, we can differing the sizes like this. That is the these are the circles. Circles you have to represent it in boxes, and some circles are represented in triangles. So finally, you have to get like this. These are the circles you have to represent. These are the boxes. These are the triangles. So with the limitations, we have to represent it with the different sizes. This is the related to the sizes, and this is related to the density of the and nearest points. We have to represent the density. The k means we have to represent it as three clusters. And here we can represent the non-globular shapes. So this is the one shape we have to represent it, and this is the we have to represent it as another shape. So now you have to divide into two different shapes. K means as represented as two clusters. So actually, this is the one shape you have to represent. This is the original points. Now you have to off of this nearest centroid. Whenever you have to represent, automatically the K means you have to arrange it into the two clusters. So this is the regarding to that K means limitations. K means limitations you have to overcome with the diagrams. See here. K means clusters we have to represent it. One solution for this one for this K means limitations solution is to use the many clusters, find the parts of the clusters but need to put together. That is the K means clusters. And the second one is the here you can represent nearest points you have to represent it with the centroid, and if the point data points are you have the distances, so you have to represent with the nearest data points along with the nearest to the centroid. That only we have to consider, and where the data points are far away from the centroid, that only we have to represent it as different clusters. That is the K means clusters we have to represent it. And in third way, that is the sizes, that is regarding to the shapes, how you can overcome this problem. So here you can overcome the problem. K means clusters you can apply. So this is the one cluster, this is the another cluster. So number of clusters you have to represent it for the shapes. So this is regarding to that K means clustering and K means algorithm we have to apply, and a similar way by K means algorithm we have to apply. Next one is the another type of clustering is the hierarchical clustering. In the hierarchical clustering produces a set of nested clusters organized as a hierarchical tree. It can be visualized in dendrogram. A tree-like diagram that records the sequence of the matches and splits. See here, this is the actual six we have to represent it with that. All the data points within the six we have to represent it. And within the four, you have to represent it as one point is inside the point and outside the point is one. So you have to represent it as four with the data points. And within the four, you have the five and two. So that you have to represent it as, yeah. And 1, 3 is you have to represent it as within the one. So you have to represent it like this. And all the values we have to within the six zone. So that we have to represent a tree-like diagram that records the sequence of matches and splits. So what is the strength of the hierarchical clustering is, you do not have that to assume any particular number of clusters. Any desired number of clusters can be obtained cutting the dendrogram at the top proper level. So they make correspond to the meaningful text, meaningful example. In biological sciences, we have to represent the reconstruction of the cells with the hierarchical clustering. So what are the hierarchical clustering? Generally, hierarchical clustering, mainly you have to divide into two types. One is the agglomerative hierarchical clustering. Second one is the divisive hierarchical clustering. So agglomerative clustering start with the points as individual clusters. At each step, measure the closest pair of clusters until only one cluster left. Second one is the another type of clustering in hierarchical is divisive. Start with the one and all inclusive cluster. At each step, split a cluster until each cluster containing a point. There are K clusters. So This is the traditional hierarchical algorithms use similarity or distance matrix. Merge or split one cluster at a time. So what is the agglomerative clustering algorithm? So this is the algorithm we have to represent the agglomerative, meritative clustering algorithm. Agglomerative clustering algorithm is the most popular hierarchical clustering technique. The basic algorithm is simply you can say that it is straightforward. Computing the proximity matrix, first one, let each data point to the cluster and repeat.
డాడీ దగ్గర ఫోన్ మమ్మీ ఫోన్ చేస్తే ఇంటికి వచ్చారు సిద్ధిగా
compute the proximity matrix that each data point to a point to be a cluster and repeat merge the all two closest clusters, update the proximity matrix so you can perform until only one single cluster remains. So here that is the agglomerative meritative relative clustering algorithm. The key operation of the computation of the proximity of the two clusters, different approaches to defining the distance between the clusters distinguish the different algorithms. So here you can see the situation. Start with the clusters is the individual points and the proximity matrix. So this is the proximity matrix for these data points. So see here, these are the values, totally how many data points are there. So here 12 data points are there. Those 12 points you have to represent it as P1 to P12. This is the proximity matrix. P1 and P1, P1, P2, P1, P3, like this, P1, P4, up to P12. Similar way, P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, up to P12. This is the proximity matrix you have to generate. Started with the individual points with the, this is the individual points. This is the proximity matrix for those data points. And second one is the intermediate situation. So this is the starting situation of these data points and the intermediate situation of the data points. So totally these are how many data points are there. So 12 data points are there. Now out of these 12 points, you have to divide, you have to group it as a 5 clusters. This is one cluster, this is another cluster, this is another cluster, this is another cluster, this is another. Totally how many clusters are there? 5 clusters are there. So this is the 5 clusters. So these clusters, you have to represent C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So these are the clusters you have to represent it here. That is the C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. These are the clusters. So totally out of 12 data points, you have to represent it with the 5 clusters, C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So this is the proximity matrix for that clusters. See here, first one is C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So here you have the 5 clusters. First cluster, you have how many data points are there? P1, P2. In second cluster, we have the P3, P4, and P5, P6, and like this up to P12. So in each cluster, how many data points are there that you have to represent it with the hierarchical manner. So intermediate situation, so you want to match the two closest clusters, C2, C5, and update the proximity matrix. So now I want to update closed matrix. I want to add the two clusters, that is the C2 and C5. So here, this is the nearest merge. These two closed clusters will be merged. So totally, how many is there? Remaining four clusters are there. C1, C2, C5, you have to represent as one cluster, C3 and C4. So now C2, what are the clusters you have to represent with the dots, and remaining you have to represent it with that, with the white representation. See here, this is the C1, C2, C3, C4. C2 will be filled with the dots, and as well as similar way, C5 is also filled with the dots. Similar way, in the column wise also, you have to fill with the C2 and C5. This is the proximity matrix for this one. So see here, these two are the five and C2. C2 cluster and C5 cluster, you have to match. So that you have to matching these, that data points you have to represent it here. After matching, so totally you have to getting C1, C2 union C5, C5 and C3, C4. So this is the matrices. So this is the C2 union C5. This is the matrices, proximity matrix you have to represent it here. And inter-cluster similarity, this is the similarity you have to represent. Mean, maximum, group average, distance between the centroids, other methods driven by the objective function, Watt's method, you have to use the squared method, you have to use the proximity matrix. So that is the P1 to P12. So similarity, minimum, maximum, group average, distance, centroids, for the so first one minimum. So which data points are minimum? That is distance we have, that you have to represent it. For the minimum, you have to find out the value, intercluster similarity. This is the minimum value. And what is the maximum value? Maximum value here, this is to here, you can represent the maximum value, maximum distance between the data points. Previously, we can represent the minimum distance between the data points. So here, we can represent the group average. So all you have to combine with the group average, you have to find out with the in the proximity matrix. Similar way, distance between the centroids. So this is the center of the first cluster, and this is the center for the second cluster. So this is the distance between these centroids. You have to find out, that is with the intercluster similarity. So here we have the cluster similarity, minimum or single link. So what are the values? We have the similarity of two clusters based on the two most similar points in the different clusters, determined by one pair of points by one link in the proximity graph. Hierarchical clustering, minimum value we have to find out like this. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is the hierarchical clustering we have to represent it here. Three, six, we have to represent it as one cluster, and 5, 2 is represented as another cluster. And these all are, we have to represent it along with the 4, and 4 we have to represent it with, along with the 1. So 1 is the maximum you have to represent. This is the nested clusters. This is the nested cluster. This is the dendrocyte. What is the strength of minimum? Minimum? How we can find? Strength of the minimum function we have to apply to this one. This is the original points. These original points we have to divide into two clusters. That is here. And handle the non-elliptical shapes. Hello. limitations of the minimum value. So you have to find out the two clusters minimum value, where the data points are nearest, that you have to find out the minimum value, sensitivity to noise, to the and outliers. Cluster similarity, maximum complete the linkage, similarity of two clusters based on the two least similar points in the different clusters. Determine the all pairs of the points in two clusters. So hierarchical clustering, maximum value you have to represent it here, and along with the dendrogram and the nested clusters you have to represent it, that approximate maximum hierarchical clustering. So what is the strength of the maximum, the original, these are the original points that you have to represent it as two clusters. Less susceptible to the noise and outliers. Limitations of a maximum, like this you have to represent it with the blue dots and another color dots you have to represent it. Tends to break the large clusters, biased towards the global clusters. Cluster similarity and the group average. So we have to find out the summation of the cluster I to J. That is, the B belongs to that cluster I, and the PJ belongs to cluster J. The summation of proximity we have to find out, P of I comma P of J divided by cluster of I into cluster of J. That is the proximity we can find out, the two cluster average of the pairwise proximity between the points. Need to use the average connectivity, scalability, and since total proximity favors of large clusters. Hierarchical clustering is a group average that you have to represent it here with the nested clusters and as well as dendrograms. So group average, we have to find out strength and limitations. Strength is less susceptible to the noise outliers, and limitation is biased and towards the globular clusters. That is the compromise between the single and complete link. Cluster similarity, that is the Watts method. Similarity of the two clusters is based on the increase and squared error with the two clusters are merged. Similar to group average, if the distance between the points is distance squared. Less susceptible to noise and outliers. Biased towards the global clusters. Hierarchical analog of k-means can be used to initialize the k-means. Hierarchical clustering is comparing minimum and maximum values. Watts method, group average method. So see the differences between the minimum, maximum, and group averages and Watts methods. So these are the clusters we have to represent it here. Nested clusters we have to represent it here. This is the time and space requirements. Order of n square space, since it uses the proximity matrix, n is the number of points. Order of n square, that is the proximity matrix. So order of n cube, you have to time to many cases. There are n steps for the, at each step is the size. N square proximity matrix must be updated and saved. The complexity of can be reduced to the order of n square log n time to some approaches. So what are the problems and what are the limitations of hierarchical clustering? Once the decision is made to combine, two clusters cannot be undone. No objective function is directly minimized. Different schemes have the problems with one or more the following. Sensitivity to noise and outliers, difficulty in handling different sizes, clusters and convex shapes. Breaking large clusters. This is regarding to this hierarchical clustering. And finally, divisive hierarchical clustering, that is the MST, minimum spanning tree we have to apply here. That is built with that minimum spanning tree for the hierarchical clustering. Start with the tree and that consists of any point. In successive steps, look for the closest pair of the points P and Q, such that one point in the current tree must be other, Q is not. Add Q to the tree and put it the edge between the P and Q. So see, this diagram will show us the connectivity of 1, 2, that is simply 5, 2, 3, and 1, 3, and 6, 3, and 4. This is the hierarchical clustering algorithm with the divisive. Compute the minimum spanning tree of the proximity graph and repeat the create a new cluster by breaking the link corresponding to the largest distance, smallest similarity, until only singleton cluster remains. This is regarding to this hierarchical clustering. So in next class we'll continue the hierarchical clustering. Is completed. Last concept is there, that is the DB scan, that is the density based algorithm. We'll continue in next hour. So in the last unit, mainly you have to getting the algorithms, either k-means algorithm or with all everything, I have to represent the k-means algorithm and bisecting k-means algorithms and hierarchical clustering algorithms. So we'll continue in next class. That is the DB scan algorithm. See the diagrams. See these diagrams related to this hierarchical clustering, comparison between the minimum, max, and group average and Ward's methods. In this diagram.